Hello, today I'm at Lidford and I'm just going to go down here, which is the start of the Granite Way. That's a bit weird. I wonder what Alabama Rot is. Here's what the bridge is actually going over. So, this is the Granite Way. Apparently it's like 11 miles long. And it starts at that point I showed you at Lidford and goes all the way up to Okehampton past several tours. I think if you saw my Sowerton tours video you would have seen it going under the bridge before you walk up to the tours at Sowerton or Sawton, however you say it. And I'm going to try walking along it because I think the weather's going to hold. It's not going to be too rainy. See how it goes. So this is quite a well-used cycle path in Devon, I think. When you go to Sowerton or when you go to Okehampton, you do see a lot of people using it. I don't know if we're still along the Lidford Gorge, but there's some kind of fast-flowing river down there. So maybe we are. Or maybe this is where the Lid comes in to the start of the Lidford Gorge, because it originates up on the moor. Some ancient cylinder. This is kind of nice. Oh, there's a curvy bench here as well. I think I've always wondered what that is. I wonder if that's part of the Granite Way. I've always wondered whether that was public ground or private ground, whatever it is. It's a hill opposite, I think we got Bratt or Widgery Cross over there coming out from the tree. There we go. So it's, we got Armstor as well. It's a hill opposite that. I've always kind of wanted to walk there, but I'm not sure if you can get through. Beautiful field here though. Look how pristine this field is. And the sun's coming out, which is really nice. So we're in a sort of bad times in the year at the moment. So I'm trying as best I can to kind of avoid crowds and things because a coronavirus has broken out of China, like some sort of plague, I think. And it's kind of scary actually, it's going all the way across the world. They call it a global pandemic. And the epicenter for Europe is Milan in Italy, where streets are like kind of like a ghost town there at the moment, and everyone's being told to stay indoors, and the hospitals are apparently overwhelmed with cases and they can't manage. And I think we're going to be 2 or 4 weeks behind Italy, and it's going to hit us next, and then it'll hit America after that, I think. So I think we're all kind of worried at the moment, and I think we all think we're all going to get it. It's just that the elderly might not survive it. I think it was like a 1 in 4 or 1 in 5 chance of like elderly people not surviving the illness. And if it can kill old people, you can imagine it must be pretty bad to get it for young people. Yeah, pretty worried at the moment. Been reading horrible things online about lung collapses and respiratory failure. Don't have any tubes or oxygen tanks at home. People in the supermarkets are buying all the toilet rolls for some reason. and hand sanitizer. So, yeah, not a good time at the moment. But hopefully out on the moors, and hopefully there's not too many crowds, I can breathe for a bit. But in a few weeks we're all gonna self-isolate, apparently. Quite a nice view over there. I think that might be the Lyd Valley. The Lydford Gorge may be running back there, at the very back. Possibly. Not 100% sure. So there are some people up there on the bit that I want to walk on. Do they look like just random public walkers, or do you reckon they own that land? Because I'd quite like to go up there. Maybe it's an area of down. But this is like a river valley, and there's a river down there somewhere. Look at this thing, what is that? It's like a bus shelter. So we are on a very, very raised bit now. Steep down the left bank. Kind of steep down the right bank too. So this one road has been raised up. And there is a river down there. It's flowing kind of brown. Wonder what that is. Got all the bird nests up there. The ground's come back up from that valley to meet us. And we're on the edge of that strange down. Look at how someone's cut all of these little dry tree stems on a big straight line. It's kind of a field of little slices. Where I saw those cut branches, that was an access gate to a bit of the down. We're on a low flat bit here. Can only just make out the tops of, I think, Arms Tor up there. It's like ponds by the sides of the track here. It's opening out after quite a big non-distinctive bit back there where you didn't have any views. Finally getting some sights. Some sort of fences here into the field. I guess they're farmer's fields fences. Although they look a bit like public access. Can't tell. We got a right turn and a lost doge. I think we might be on the edge of the Bridderstow Road, which we might have to cross to continue along this. Yeah, I think we're there. It's quite nice and wooded here, and you can see the tors. Yep, that's where we are. I believe that's Great Links up there. This is a long road between the Fox and Hounds pub, I believe, and the village of Bridderstow. Which is quite a nice village, but it's a bit out of the way. Not quite sure even if it has bus links. Village for drivers. Lovely opening out here. What is this? What? Okay. This means anyone can go on that, except cars and motorcycles, I guess, and trucks. That's expected. So I believe that is Great Links Tor. That looks like maybe Great Noddon. That could be the edge of the Saraton Tors, or maybe it's... Oh no, actually that's where I was the other day. Branscombe's Loaf. Probably not visible here, but that would be Corn Tor on Corn Ridge, I'm pretty sure. And then Saraton Tors, which obviously we're going to get a better view of because this track goes all the way there.
farm crossing. It's someone's farmy house up here. Some kind of old shack, and I can hear running water. There's a, I guess, some kind of stream down here.
What's down here?
Ah, there's like tributaries of more than one stream all meeting together. That's interesting. Another farm crossing. It looks more like a footpath down a valley. It looks like a bit of storm damage in that field. Lots of kind of uprooted trees and things. That's where the road goes there, and Great Noddon is up there. I seem to remember from the bus that we're actually going to be going under the main road in a minute and coming out on the other side nearer the tours. Yep, here we go. This must be where the cars go, I think. Didn't realise it was so high up when you're driving on there. It feels like you're not elevated that much, to be honest. Yeah, still alongside Great Noddon. I think we've gone past the top of it. Another farm crossing, past the road bridge. More broken twigs. Feel these. I think that's another river we're gonna cross in a bit. Another river valley coming up. Wonder which one that is. Weird post here. Wonder if it used to be an electrical pole or something. What does that say? B! Or 8, I don't know. And there's a stream sort of down there. Some old concretey World War II looking things here. Not sure what they are. And look at this vast expanse here of this field. That's pretty huge. We're kind of high up here. Guess that's like a steep cliff to my right. There's a treetop and it's been cut flat. That's kind of cool. I wonder how windy it is on Great Noddon today. It's pretty damn windy when we got to the top of it that day. We've got another bridge coming up here. That can't be the road again, can it? Do we weave southerly down? Do we weave under the road multiple times? Oh, all right, mate. All right, mate. These weird swan-like granite waymarkers up here. Yeah, not sure what goes over this bridge. Maybe it used to be one of the old railways. What's this sign say? Fogarty's Bridge. Oh, that Fogarty. Some of these banks are all rock. I wonder if they TNT'd through a tor or like solid granite in order to just originally create this path. And I wonder who did that. Because this all looks man-made to me. You got a path, and then steep banks either side. So who originally blew the holes for this path? It's a little stream there between two ponds. This one must be elevated. What's growing in there? Very green mossiness. Still going down this valley path. It's getting a little bit lower on our left side. Maybe we'll see something. Another farm crossing. Not at Mildon yet. That's some towering gorse. Some kind of old wall there with a little dug-in alcove. A bit castle-y. Cycle route 27. Are we crossing cycle route 27 or... No, that's the farm crossing, isn't it? There's a river gurgling over there somewhere. Maybe a stream. Oh no, there's a river rushing up there somewhere. Oh no, of course we're not at Mildon yet. What am I talking about? We haven't even passed the Sowerton Tours. They're right in front of me. Another streamy there with a blue hose pipe. Old bridge here seems to go over it. I can hear the road rumbling off that direction now. We're more inland from it to the moor. Oh, I think I know where we are now. I think we're in a place called Lake, where there's the pub called the Bears Lake Inn, and there's a big viaduct somewhere. I don't actually know the history of the Granite Way. Did this actually used to be one of the old railways that they dismantled? Because here's another one of those huts. It makes me maybe think that. And it would make more sense as to why they blasted a huge valley out of the rock back there. Surely make more sense than just doing it for a footpath. Feel the blue dudes here. Used to be a way through, maybe, isn't now. Big chunky granite bench. And hey, this splinters off into another path for some reason. Where's it going? Lake Village and Broderstow. Steep hill ahead. Oh, I see, it kind of jags. It doesn't go back here, it jags down there. Are we quite high up here? Does it go underneath us? There's a bridge up ahead. There's someone cycling down that steep moorland hill there. It's a different flower, I'm not quite sure what that is. Coming out the same time as the daffs. I have got to wonder actually, are we going over the viaduct? That'd be weird and unexpected. Oh shit, we are. I wondered how you got on top of that. 1874, my kind of era. Put my top hat on while going over this bridge, if I had it. There's some cyclists actually trying to tackle the moor. I don't know how you'd even do that. Especially going up. I guess you could ride down that. Maybe that's why they do it. They go up there and then they go down that slope. So this is where that path goes. It doesn't seem to go under the viaduct though. It seems to go all the way over there. I reckon the railway must have used to go along this viaduct here. There's where I was the other day after my massive walk to Branscombe's Loaf. That one, I wasn't sure whether it was East Tor or just the edge of the Sowerton Tor's rock outcrop, if I can talk. So that's what that valley is to the side. Some kind of stream goes there. And then on the other side, there's a fairly big river, well, fairly big stream, small river there. That's big island, I guess, because the river's going up there, and there's a river over here, coming up here, I think. That's interesting, we're on a kind of island. The viaduct is crossing multiple little rivers from the moor. From those two valley-like grooves. Look over there, how field becomes moor. Big green grassy space full of sheep. Rough, crazy moorland area. So what do they do to the grass exactly? to make it just a sudden difference across that vast distance to this vast distance. Farming, kind of interesting. Since this technically could be a tour video, are you liking this? Yeah, did I mention there might be a tour called Meldon Wood Rocks near the big bridge we're approaching later on? There's a little path that goes off here. It says Sowerton Tours. Little footpath. If there was a railway that used to be here around the 1800s, 1900s, when they blasted all this rock, would have liked to have seen it. Another rail bridge we're going under here. Gates ahead. Access is permitted when the gates are unlocked. Respect the landowner's wishes. Does that mean someone can lock the gates on you on the Granite Way? Well, I've seen tons of people coming down from Okehampton, so on their bikes, so I don't know why it would be locked off. Look at this. This does look like a tor that has been blasted open. Unfortunately, it's not a marked tor, so... So I wonder what's on top of this one. This could just be a footpath that used to go over the old railway. I'm just going to assume right now that this was the old railway. Although, the path does get messier over there. Cycle route 27. No horse riding. What's this say? You are here. Okay. There's a way I could have gone round, apparently. The green route. I didn't actually see where that was. Oh, that must have been the Sowerton Tours route. Yeah, it came off, didn't it? It didn't say anything about taking that route to cut out this. Railway path. Both end up at Sowerton. I did not know that, that's strange. Well, I don't think it's locked. We do get to see a waterfall. All these mossy branches here. This is a bit of a different landscape, isn't it? Crazy. I don't know, this section looks a little bit less like it used to be part of the railway. But then again, what's that? It's a weird fence here. This could be some old railway related thing, so maybe. Ah, we've got the road again here. Little gate there. And the road is down there, the road I'm familiar with. And up there, starting to see the Sowerton Tours. Another rail bridge here. And it says Woodman's Bridge. Any reason for this bench? I don't think it provides that much of a view, does it? A view of the road. I didn't know the road was here too. Oh, a sunny day maybe. There's a village down there, some sort. I hope I'm not breathing in the miasma. Is that what the medieval people called it? Miasma? In the time of plague, they said infection travelled by a foul air that clouded the landscape. Could be a bridge here, not sure. Could be a wall. There's someone's house down there. Can't hear a stream or river. Yeah, this is a bridge. There's another house over there, I think. First I thought I was smelling that kind of crayons smell you get on the moor, but then it got stronger and I realised it was just the kind of animal poop that's around here. Ugh. Starts off as primary school crayon smell and then just increases. I can see the Sowerton Church! And there's the bridge you go over. Can't see it too well there, but there's a stream. I think it runs under the footpath from over there. There's a kink in the path here that just seems to go around benches for some reason. Don't quite understand what that's about. Fair enough. Here we are, familiar territory. There's a stream coming down there, I didn't know that. This is a bridge I was up the other day that goes up to the Sowerton Tors. Sowerton 200 metre, is it really that far? There's the old Sowerton Church. Except this time, we're going to keep walking. Little Sowerton Tors up there. Always a nice walk. This looks once again like we're in railway territory. Could have been an old railway under this. Now, we're going up from Sowerton towards... I can hear my voice echoing. Melbourne. And I'm not quite sure if this is going to be a very long bit of the journey or not. We'll see. But there's a big footbridge over the valley at Melbourne. And after we've crossed it, that's where we might find our tour. Maybe. No promises. So we're kind of passing the edge of the Sowerton Tors. Oh, I remember before I went up there towards Branscombe's Loaf. There's that bit that the Granite Way crosses called Prooley Moor. I guess I'll be up there again. Little marshy bit there. Yeah, this is looking a little bit like the Prooley Moor section that you walk up the shallower side of the Sowerton Tors from. That weird contraption there. Cylindrical gate. Let's see how snake-like the path can be. That was an Aladdin reference. The good one, not the shit new one. Little stream there, and there's the road. I was wondering if with perspective I could make a heart shape out of that arch, but I don't think it's working. It's not quite working out. The top bit needs to be cut in a certain shape. Here we are at Prooley Moor again. There's good old Branscombe's Loaf. Can we see the rocks? I don't know, man. And now coming up is that cattle grid where I walked from before. Just down there. Man, that was a long journey when I went up there, wasn't it? I still haven't figured out quite how many miles that was. I wonder if this journey is going to be longer. It's going to be kind of a sense of achievement having walked all the way from Lidford to Okehampton, not going to lie. So this time, that's where we're going, that's where we came from, that's where we're going. Oh yes, it's also Cycle Route 27, if you need to know that. And this is the cattle grid and the main road at Sowerton Cross, where there's service stations and a Burger King and a Subway and the entrance to the dual carriageway for you there. Don't know where that goes. I should go and have a look. That's a bit odd. Is that a tour? Can I call that a tour? Some weird wooden frigging shelter, I guess. I guess if you were homeless, you could kip on this for a bit. Oh look, it's... how weird. It's kind of like a curvy... what do you call those? Triskelions? Yeah! It's like a curvy triskelion. Like the three-pronged spiral-shaped thing. Nice! Shelter for three homeless people, or campers, or I don't know. So what are we going to name this tour? I christen you Road Tour. So now I'm going to be interested to know what the path starts to do now as we veer away from all the roads. Well, this footpath can't possibly go to Ilfracombe, surely. How would it go to Ilfracombe? That's the north coast. It's raining now. God damn it. I think over here on the side of the roads is a cycle hire place, which is maybe crossed with a pub. Here we go. You can see the Sowerton Tours up there being swallowed up by the mist and Branscombe. The drizzly rain has come for me. Access to a high tree stump there. Yet another rail bridge here. There's, I think, the same ad for that place again. Bike and pub thing. And the road seems to spring off towards it if you want to go up there. The path, sorry. It's like a load of earth fell into the path at some point, which is why all the ground's all muddy here, I guess. Maybe it was recent from the storms we had, Storm Ciara or whatever. So, yeah, maybe that bank all fell down into the path and they've only just cleared it. Kind of fresh excavations. Pretty nondescript landscape again for a bit. Like that bit we went through before. High walls, ponds on either side. What's that? It's like some kind of... I thought it was a seat, but it's more like a log. Or maybe it's a piece of granite. It's granite. I suppose it must be a kind of bench. The colour of that rock strikes me as kind of blue with flecks of dark red in it. All the gorse is like growing on a vertical rock slope up there. Strange. Does this one say S? Or a glimpse of something a bit tall like up there? I don't know if I can see it through the trees. Weird kind of mini bridge here, I guess. Is there a Strem? That's not even worth having a bridge for. Yeah, so far this bit of the path, Granite Way, has been not very exciting. A bit rubbish, as landscapes go. I'm sure it will improve the nearer we get to Meldon. It's a little bit samey here with all the farmers' fields. Maybe it looks nice in sunshine. This looks like some kind of Cub Scouts bushcraft kind of meetup area. Either that or they tried to design a church and gave up after putting the pews in. I guess the kind of the focus would be up here. 200 watt though. 200 what? 200 Waterloo? Is this an address? Ah, we got a bit of railway kind of history going on here. Southern Railway, site of Melvin Junction signal box. Waterloo, 199.77 miles. Waterloo Station in London? Is that amount away or? Look at this. God, it's so bright, I almost mistook it for something that was backlit by electricity, but no. That's what it looked like here. Where? Just like behind here or something? The isolated and exposed Meldon Junction signal box, opened in 1878 as Meldon Loop, was the highest box on the Southern's standard gauge, I don't know what that means, the Transport Treasury. Line opened 12th of October, 1874. There's actually a road down there, I think. Yeah, a full-on road, and there's a car coming down it now. Can't quite see, but it's there. Another one of these fellas. This is a lot less well decorated than the other ones. They kind of gave up on this one a little bit. Sowton, Lidford, Royal Bank of Scotland, oh god. Meldon Reservoir. Okay, maybe we can walk to it from here. Not sure if the track is mapped. Meldon Viaduct. Oh, that's what we're going to. Wait, how long did it say? Half a mile. Okay, half a mile. What's that? Bike storage? I don't quite understand. Bridge number 615. Oh, we're actually above a full-on road here. A little baby tank here. Yep. World War One tanks made out of tractors. I wonder if we're going up like there. Another railway bridge. This one says catch points, which I think is some train definition. Some train terminology. Actually, it's got something on the side of it here. Ah, I think we're at a valley. I think we might be here at Meldon Reservoir. Sorry, not Meldon Reservoir, that's further up, but Meldon Viaduct. Yes, we are, I think. There's an old train there, I think. Possibly. So this is a path that goes up to the right bank. Can we make out the... These are a bit slippery looking. Can we make out the Meldon Wood Rocks? I don't know if we'll be able to climb down there. That's pretty steep. They're in there somewhere though. Yeah, they're in that wood over there. Let's get back on the viaduct. I think there's a Samaritan's poster here. Talk to us if you're thinking of committing suicide. Maybe people have tried. Meldon Viaduct, beware of high winds. I can't remember there being a cafe around here, that seems a bit weird. Where would they put it? Okay, can we see Meldon Reservoir here from here? Probably not. Oh wait, oh it's over there, okay, yes. You can see the dam, you can't see the water. So the car park's tucked in there to the right. I'm wondering if that's a tour I haven't been to up there. Might be. Up here is Longstone Hill from the other side, from where we are previously. Don't know what's going on down there, some kind of gathering. That's a bit of Meldon Quarry, I think. And there's another bit of Meldon Quarry up there. There's some people not avoiding gatherings. I hope they're not coofing on each other. Other side here, and look at all these crows in this tree here. Look at them all. And I guess that's the river we're going over right now. A little path up there. The drizzle is kind of swallowing everything up. All this rain coming here. So I wanted to go and see the Meldon Wood Rocks, which is a tour that is actually down here. But unfortunately, by the looks of it, looks like a very steep bank on either side. Very steep. So maybe I'll get a glimpse of something. There's the old train there. It's got to be down there somewhere. Not currently seeing anything. There are some steps there. Perhaps that's a way. There's a bunch of old railway stuff here. Let's go over here. That's like the end of the line. There's a tour behind. Which tour is that? I think that's Longstone Hill behind there. Meldon Buffet. Buffet closed. Public footpath to the moor and Meldon Reservoir. So maybe. Can't go in there. Old bike rack thing. Bits of disused. What's that? Okay. Disused railway. So, we'll take a quick look down here. That's the best way we can do it, I think. Which also actually affords us a nice view of the big iron construction that we were standing on. Look at that black monster there. Well, this could possibly give us a view of the tour, I don't know. Monster. Oh, I just got dripped on in the eye. There's actually someone standing just underneath the bridge there. So if you want to see it, here's the location of the Meldon Wood Rocks. They actually look maybe a bit closer to the river than I thought. We walked along from where my thumb is now to where that blue line is and then went down. So here's the base, one of the bases of the bridge, the viaduct. There is a rock here. A rock is not a tour. All sorts of things. I don't want to go under the bridge because that'll take me away from what I want to find. Ideally, I want to go over here. So there might be... There's the rock we saw, I think. There's some more rocks clearly here. I'm wondering if this is it or part of it. This could be it. Have a look around. See if there's anything else. Ah. Yeah, I think that might possibly be it. Although it is kind of under, that is under the bridge, isn't it? Maybe the map got it wrong. Let's continue up here. So maybe slightly away from the bridge, as far as the map I've got. And there are some rocks here as well. There's some rocks. There's some rocks up there as well. Ah, yeah, that's This is probably it, just the rocks in general around here. Let's be careful because it's all muddy here today. I've only got one hand for balance. That footpath goes down there. Yeah, I think this is probably it. There we go. The Meldenwood Rocks. There's your other ones again, under the viaduct. Tucked into a tree. We're back at the top again. Steps are kind of steep. Okay, we're getting back down to Oakhampton. 2.5 miles this time. An old visitor centre with buffet that is all shut down now. What do you think of these toilets? Unisex toilets, except disabled people. Oh, I bet the SJWs will have something to say about that. Quarries are not play areas. Bodmin. What the hell? This is a bit weird. Like a road sign here. Trespassing penalty, £200. Oh, that's the edge of the quarry. Ah, we're at Meldon Quarry. You can kind of see it over there. I guess they used to ship a ton of rock up from here. Are they doing anything with this? Is the trespassing £200 thing part of like a nanny state kind of thing? You get fined for your safety. Just let people, you know, make mistakes, why not? They've put some white rock they've mined all together in a clump over there for some reason. That is. And on the other side we have a mossy wood. Like an old Half-Life 1 style train yard there. Dead trains. Danger of death. 11,000 volts. When you get to Oakhampton, this train line becomes kind of active. I think they've done it up so that there are actually occasional trains going between Oakhampton and Exeter City. I think it was out of commission for a long time, but now it's kind of working again. Not this bit though. Going over a stream down there, and I can hear the dual carriageway ferocious back there. These rusted iron monument. There's some kind of flowing water there. It looks quite light coloured, so maybe there's clay under it. I don't know. Strange flowing waterway over there. Deep and cold. Ah, some steps here. So where do they lead? Emmett's Folly Viewpoint. Not gonna go there though. That's where we've been. Oakhampton Station, now 2 miles. On a sunny day, maybe the viewpoint would be a good idea, but isn't a folly meant to be like a fake castle to throw people off the scent? People who are looking for castles, like real castles. Hey, what are you doing there, El Diablo? What are you doing there, El Diablo? It's quite a steep slope. It is kind of steep. Actually, we're like suspended right now, I think. Oh, see what's down there. We're like suspended on a footbridge, I think. Check this out. Sheep have privileges that humans don't. No kids playing on the tracks like a playground, but if you're a sheep, absolutely. What you doing, mates? You gonna pay £200? Hiya. I think they're gonna pay. Oh come on, that's gotta be like a kind of tour, right? Look at that. You even got a bench overlooking it, like there it is. It's like a tour. Wait, what are you looking at? Mini tour. I christened that mini tour. Can you see the lum? Can you see the little lum? I see the lum. Hello, lum. Tiny one. Do that again. Do it again. Do it again. Oh, there we go. There we go. I think we're gonna go beside or directly under the road in a minute. Such a racket. I don't actually know which one it is at this point. There's two ways, what the hell? What's that say? Mary Michael Pilgrim's Way. Which one is? That way or that way? This has got a steep view at the end of it. Aren't underpasses like one of the creepiest things humans have ever invented? This is fucking creepy, man. At least I'm not in a city. So hopefully I won't get shanked at random. Well, I mean, it's not necessarily saying the Granite Way, but it's saying Cycle Route 27. So... oh yeah, maybe I can follow it. It's a big field here. Just an open access kind of a field. Not 27. These are a bit tour-like. There's a few rocks in the ground here. I asked a guy back there, he said yes, this is the one. This is the Granite Way, still goes to Okehampton Station, so good. But down there, that's where I looked before. All those rocks there. Like a little rock garden. I wonder if there's a stream between them or what. This is weird. Bridge, here's a stream. The stream goes under the road here. This weird giant contraption. It's quite a pretty stream when it comes out. One and a half miles. See another stream there running under us. Still by the ugly dual carriageway. Another stream coming up here. Comes from under us. Big concrete thing. It's quite cool, isn't it? It's like decorated with rocks. It's like someone blew up an explosive barrel around here. Are we in a video game? So this has probably been the hardest bit to endure, is walking alongside this dual carriageway. But I think we're on the edge of Okehampton now, so I can see Okehampton Castle. Also another rail bridge, which we're going to go to the left of. Yeah, I have actually walked on this bit of the Granite Way before. I just didn't follow it all the way through like we did today, all the way to Lidford. Army guys there, I think, from Okehampton Camp or something. I'm not sure what's going on there. So the Granite Way is going to end very soon, but I might just take you past the ending of it to see Okehampton Station. So it says air training cadets here, apparently, and they're like classrooms in some of these bunkers, I think. Bunkers. What do you call them? Not bunkers. Frigging weird makeshift buildings with thin walls. A big, rich-looking house there, and a scary symbol. Coming up over there, you can just make out Okehampton Station from the inside. And right here is where the Granite Way ends. So I'll just show you a little walk to the outside of the station, but apart from that, thank you for watching.